Hello, my name is Gabriel from GabakUSA. In this video, we are going to talk about troubleshooting, how to troubleshoot the CPU. If you're having some problem, the CPU is not working properly for any reason, you are going to have two main issues. One, the CPU might be faulty, and another one might be overheating. So first of all, we are going to start with the theory first. If this is the first video, I recommend you to start from the beginning in the playlist, so that way you are going to become a computer technician. So I'm going to talk more about other things. So first, theory, later, practice. In the other video that I'm going to make, I'm going to show you in a little bit, is how the CPU is affected by the heat, so that way you are going to see all the effects, and if you see it in the real world, in the customer, you will know what to do. So first of all, what you're going to see is two different things. We are going to talk first about overheating. So the first symptom that you're going to see, or the most common, is slowness. So the computer will be slow, and you're wondering, well, what's going on? So another thing that is very common is Windows, you're going to see the blue screen of death, that is the error, and you have to reset the computer, or the computer will restart by itself. And another, by the excess of temperature, the CPU will turn off or will shut down the computer by itself. So, and then you have to reboot it, and you will see all these kind of problems, and you don't know how to fix it. Okay, now I'm going to tell you the causes. So the first cause will be dirt. If you have a lot of dirt on the heatsink, that will be the main issue. Here I have one that is from an old computer. Usually, I mean, this is kind of pretty clean. I mean, this one was like very dirty. I clean it. But usually when you open up the computer and you have the heatsink inside, sometimes if you go to the customer have cats, dogs, and everything else, you're going to see that if the computer wasn't being in the shop, in your shop, or it didn't have any maintenance for a very long time, you will see that it's all filthy. And of course, the heat will not dissipate. If it's all clogged up by dirt and everything, it will be very difficult for the computer to be able to dissipate all the temperature. So that will be one of the first things that you're going to find. So if you have a compressor or something like that, you're going to be able to fix this kind of things. Another issue might be too much or too little thermal paste. So that is another thing. When you build the computer, or maybe you're doing maintenance or something like that, maybe you don't know who built the computer before. Sometimes people think that the CPU and the heatsink is like a sandwich, and they use all tons of thermal compound and or thermal paste. They think that the much the better, but usually it's not like that. When you have to do a maintenance or something like that, try to use as little as possible, so just enough, so the heat will be dissipated by the heatsink, and that way everything will work fine. So if you want, you can make a test. Yeah, you can try to apply whatever you think is good, and try to take the measurement, the temperature, and you will see how much temperature do you have at that moment, and then maybe take it out again, try to remove more of the thermal compound, and then put it back again and see the difference. I have a play with these on notebooks when I repair them, and you will see that maybe it drops like 2 or 3, even 5 degrees less. So just by using like very little, like a very tiny bit of a thermal compound, and that is awesome. So make tests. Maybe in another video I'm going to teach you how to apply the thermal compound, so that way you're going to see everything. And number three, a fan failure. So that is very common. Usually with the original heatsink, you will see that the fans are not that good. Sometimes you will see that they got stuck, or maybe because the dirt and the heat and everything, and the engine will blow up, so they will stop working. And the only way to repair it will be to replace the heatsink, or you can replace just the fan if you want. Also, what you can do in those cases, if you don't want to worry about that, you can install one of these models. I like a lot because they are like very bulky. They have a lot of surface to dissipate the temperature. Even if the fan is off or is unplugged, I try with this computer, I'll show you later on. The temperature is pretty low. Usually if you have the CPU is between 30 degrees Celsius and 60, you will be okay. If you have above that, usually the performance is going to decrease. If you have 90, 100, you're doomed. So prefer to avoid those things. Otherwise, the life expectancy of the CPU is going to decrease a lot. So that is another thing. Here I have another heatsink. I like it a lot. This is very big. It's bigger than the one I just showed you. Maybe in another video I'm going to show you how to install it and how to do everything else. But I like it, this a lot. I tried with the customer because just this customer. Another thing I'm going to talk about later on is when the base breaks and the heatsink falls. That is another big issue. So I'm going to show you here. I have a motherboard, and usually this is a very old one. And here you have the plastic one. I have seen this many times. When you see, I'm going to show you very closely. So as you can see here, these little ends here, sometimes they break off, and the heatsink will fall. So when the heatsink fall, of course, it's not going to be touching all the surface of the CPU and the computer, or will be very slow, like I said, very slow, or it will shut off by itself. So that is the main thing. What I like about this heatsink that I just show you here, this is the model is Hyper 212 Evo. The brand is Schoolmaster. It's all metal, so the good thing, at least few years ago when I installed one of them, the thing is, this instead of being plastic in this side, in the other side is all one piece of metal, in the other side is metal, so there is no chance that this will break or will crack over time because the heat and everything else. So that is very important. So another thing is cause will be fan failure. So you have two options. One, a broken fan. And if that happens, just replace it. Or if it starts making noise, you can use oil. Maybe if it is Sunday and you're thinking, well, there is no place to get the new fan, or maybe you have to order it in Amazon, it will take a few days. Okay, maybe you can use oil. If you do that, try to use some oil with Teflon, and that is great. Usually lasts a little bit longer. Don't use WD-40, usually doesn't work that well. Another option would be no power. So sometimes I've seen in this kind of, in any motherboard, that the power, the connector, for some reason, it doesn't have electricity. Maybe there is a failure in the motherboard. If that is the issue, replace the motherboard. In another case, if you're thinking, well, it's Sunday, I don't have any other place, or I have to wait a few days until the thing arrives to my home, office, or whatever, in order to repair the computer. Maybe you can just cut the cables. Here, I'm going to show you in this case. So if you have a cable like that, you can just cut it and then join it to the power supply, and that way it should work. I mean, the bad thing if you are doing that is the problem is the fan is going to be full speed all the time. Usually with the motherboards, they have some system that they regulate the speed. So when the CPU is idle, in idle mode, it's not being used 100%, or maybe 5, 10% or something very little, it was going to produce very little heat. So that way you don't need a full speed of the heatsink. So that way you're going to have a quiet computer. Otherwise, if you are thinking, well, the computer is making a lot of noise, it's because of that, because the power supply is going to provide 12 volts and the fan will be spinning full speed all the time. So that is the main thing. So if you don't know about the, like I said before, the connector, so here is the connector, and here is what you have to think. Some people, if they don't know what they are doing, they're going to connect this maybe in another place, because remember the motherboard, it says here on the side, usually it will say CPU, so here is where you have to have the connector. I just show you, if you connect it maybe where it says system or any other place, when you power up the computer, it will say no CPU fan detected, and you have to press F1 to continue, or it will shut off by itself. So that is another thing that you have to consider when you are going to do some repairs. So like I said before, if that's happened, the power supply trick will help you. Otherwise, you can try to find another. If sometimes the motherboard have more than one connector, so you can connect it in another place. That is good. But if you go to the BIOS, or maybe if you're going to use some kind of software to check the temperature or the RPMs, you're not going to be able to see, because it's not going to be able to sense it, because you're using the wrong connector. So that is the main thing. Okay, another issue that you may find, bad connector, maybe the connector is broken for any reason. Another will be unplugged. Sometimes people, they will call you to say, hey, my computer is not working, and they have been playing inside of the computer already, and you may find that the connector is unplugged for any reason. And the other point will be number four, broken mounting support. Like I said before, I show you the plastic thing. So if it is broken, the heatsink will fall. Try to use heatsink with all metal heatsink. That is great. Okay, let's talk about faulty CPUs. So it's very rare to see a CPU that is not working, but I've seen it very, very, very few. So in that case, there might be few issues with this. One of them that I've seen a few times is the motherboard, for some reason, instead of providing maybe X amount of voltage to the CPU, is providing more, so that way the CPU may burn or will last less, or the CPU, the life expectancy will be very, very low because of that. You may see blue screen of death. Sometimes you're going to see maybe errors that is going to beep when you power up the computers. It might beep, depending on the motherboard, and you have to see the codes. And another thing that you may see is a black screen. You just turn it on and nothing happens. So that is the other thing. So if you want to check the CPU and make sure that everything is good, what you can use is one of the, there are few free CPU stress software over there on internet. So there are a few. So one of them is Heavy Load. I like it a lot. It's very simple to use and it's free. So that is great. The only thing you have to do is just download it, click on play. There is a play button, and it will use your CPU 100%. That way you can leave it if you want 24 hours, 48 hours, and usually if the computer has some kind of issue, it will not last, not even 5 minutes. The CPU, the temperature will be like 100%. That is very good. So if you want to try to see if the heatsink that you're using is good or not, that is a very good trick. So that way you can leave it for a while and then measure the temperature, so you know that the CPU, using the CPU 100% with, I don't know, maybe this heatsink is great. Otherwise, maybe something bigger, maybe water cooling or something like that, but that is the thing. Another thing that you can do if you are in the customer and you don't want to open up the computer case or something like that, or maybe the computer case is in a very weird place and is not that it's not that easy to try to open it up and see. You can enter in the BIOS, and then you can check the temperature, you can check the RPMs, and that way you know if everything is good or not. If you go to the BIOS and you say, hey, it's 80 or something like that, you can even, sometimes you can set the different alarms that, so the computer will beep if the temperature reached certain decrease, and also to shut off the computer. So you can do whatever depending on the BIOS. And now I'm going to show you in the real world how the computer acts using more temperature, less temperature, and playing with the heatsink. I hope you will enjoy it. Now we are going to start with the practice. Like I told you before, here we have a software, it's called CAMPC, and it tells you the speed of the fan, like I said before, the temperature, load, temperature of the video card, but in this case we don't care about the video card, but the main thing would be CPU. So here we have a multimeter, here we have a thermocouple, and in this case we have in Celsius, but if we touch here, we're going to see it's going to change, so it's like 26, and it should be close to 40. So, because this is in Celsius as well, I don't know if I can change it, surely I can. Switch settings, general, Fahrenheit. There you go, change it, there you go, now I have it in Fahrenheit. As you can see, 108, and here we are going to do the same. We press here, and it's 90, so it's very, very close. So you can do the conversion if you want to, and it works like a charm. So now I'm going to just leave it hanging. This will power down or shut off by itself, so in a while. And we see here all the systems. So what we are going to do is we're going to shut down the computer. I'm going to start it all over again, so that way you're going to see. So it will take a little bit. We have the power supply, hard drive, and all those things. So now the computer is off. And like I said before, here is the heat sink. Here is the heat sink. So as you can see, it has dirt. So let's hope you can focus very well. So it has a lot of dirt. This computer is old. It doesn't have any thermal paste. This is a used computer, of course. So this is something that I used to make this kind of test. And on the CPU, it doesn't have any thermal paste either. So we will see how it behaves when I remove the heatsink and all those things. So now I'm going to plug this in again. And remember what I said before about the connector and the plastic. So here I have the other motherboard. So here is what I've been connecting right now. So make sure that it says CPU fan. I'll try to zoom in. I hope you can see it better. So it should say CPU fan over there. So this is the same thing that we have here. So now we are going to use our magic screwdriver. We're going to turn it on, and we're going to turn it on and enter in the BIOS so you can see how it looks like. So I'll try to zoom in. There you go. So now we have to go here where it says power, and then we go where it says hardware monitor, enter. We wait a few seconds and you will see the speed of the fan. In this case, we have the temperature, it's 53. I mean, it's okay because the CPU is, I mean, it's barely touching the heatsink. Here we have the RPM, it's about 2000. And we have the profiles. In this case, we have a quiet. If you want to change it, you can do this, change it, silence, turbo. In this case, it's silence, so that way it will not make that much noise. Here, it will say Q. A Q fan is so that way you can control it. Otherwise, if I disable it, you will not have that option and the fan will be full speed all the time. So basically here you have the motherboard. In this case, we don't care about that. And as you can see here, you can choose it as ignore. So the bad thing, if you leave it like that, the heatsink, the fan is not connected, of course it will not send you any error. So in this case, what I'm going to do is I'm going to unplug the fan. As you can see, here is the core, and here we have the heatsink. So as you can see, the temperature is rising very quickly, and if we leave it like that over, like when it reach like 100 or something like that, the computer will shut off by itself. So now I'm going to leave it. So as you can see here, we have 54 Celsius or 131 Fahrenheit. So if I remove the heatsink, as you can see here, now the temperature is going to rise. Also, the fan is disconnected, and see here where it says ignore, I will change it. I'll set it like not available. So as soon as I connect this, you will see that it will start working. So remember, if it reached the 190, that would be too bad. Let's try always to keep it as cool as possible. Now I'm going to connect the fan. So that way you're going to see, as soon as I do that, you will see the speed over here. So that is how it works. So that is good. Now I'm going to zoom out a little bit. As you can see, you can hear it. All right, now I'm going to unplug it. And as you can see, now I'm going to restart the computer. And you should see the error that I'm going to show you right now. Now I'm going to shut down the computer. That way, the message, you will see it, because the computer already booted up, so surely that is why it's not showing the error. Disconnected this fan. So we disconnected the fan, and now we're going to proceed to turn on the computer. So as you can see, now we are going to see in a little bit, it will say fan error. That is what I was talking about. So that is very important in this case. You will see that you can press tab sometimes if you want to get rid of the main screen, if you want to see. And here we have the fan error. So I hope you can see it. Otherwise, I'll try to zoom in the screen. Okay, as you can see here, it says CPU fan error. So we have two options. One, press F1, and then the computer will continue without it, or we can just connect it and turn off the computer again. In this case, we're going to press F1, you will see it will boot up just fine. But that is one of the things that you're going to see when you start working with the computer. So now I'm going to move the camera the way it was before, and the way you can see it better. Okay, now the computer has boot up. Now we are going to show you one little software that works great. Also, you can work with your cell phone as well. It's called CamPC. Now I'm going to try to get it on my cell phone as well. And this is the software. So as I hope you can see it great. So everything that is going on the computer, you will see it here as well. Okay, great. Now we have the software up and running. As you can see, we have the temperature in Fahrenheit. And we have the CPU load. We're going to press Control Alt. We are going to press, I just press Control Shift Escape. That way you're going to see the same thing here. As you can see, very low usage. So we're going to move it here. There is a new, another software that will help you. If you want, I'll try to use this one. It's called Heavy Load. I like it a lot. And we're going to play it, and that's it. So now the CPU, as you can see, is 100% here. So we're going to try to zoom in so you can see things better. So here is 100%, all the CPUs. So all the cores, that is what I'm saying. And here it takes a while to update because it's taking all the resources of this computer, and this CPU is not that very powerful. And if we do the same thing on the cell phone, it should do the same thing, but as you can see, it's 1% here. But surely, I'm quite sure if we could have a powerful computer, everything should be better. There you go. As you can see, it's still 1%. So, but if I stop the heavy load here, when I want to stop it, in a little bit, it should update here. But I'm going to run something that is not going to be that intensive, at least 40%. So you can see how it works just great. The thing is, we have a very old CPU here, but for the test, I mean, if you want to see if the CPU is working right or not, with this test, it would be okay. You can leave it like a few hours, like I said before. Here we have another software. This one is very good. You can check the resolution that you want. In this case, we are going to run it in a low resolution, so that way we can have multiple things running at the same time. And we are going to leave this here. We're going to leave this here. As you can see, now we have 50%. I'm going to close the other one, the heavy load. This is the software that I was saying. And here on the Windows, as you can see here, we have almost 50% running this animation here. And we're going to move it just in one side. And we have 20% load here, 50. And it reflects the same thing here. So I'm going to show you. As you can see, it works better because it's not taking 100%. So 50%, 50% here, 50, almost the same thing here. And you have everything that you want in the palm of your hand. So if you want to see the temperature, CPU usage, also if you're downloading something, uploading anything, you can see everything with this app. So this app is great. I'm going to try to zoom in. So you see, so as you can see here, you see the up and down, the CPU usage, the temperature, and everything else. So here we have in Celsius, over there we have in Fahrenheit, and we have everything, the memory RAM, the space available on the hard drive, and everything. So be saying that, just try to download it, CAM PC, like I said before. I like it, this software. So now I'm going to show you something else. So now, as you can see, we have the animation and everything. I'm going to try to zoom out. I'm going to show you when I disconnect the heatsink how everything is affected. So now I'm going to zoom out, so that way you're going to see how the performance is affected by the heat. So as you can see, I still have the temperature is high, and I don't have the fan working. As you can see, it's unplugged still, and now we see that it's startling. It's not working smoothly, and now if I remove it, if you see, we don't have anything, and maybe it's going to freeze or it's going to move very slowly. And as soon as we put this, and this will lower the temperature, everything will be back to normal. So now what I'm going to do, as you can see, we are in 20, 30, 40, now 40. So now things are going back to normal. I'm going to connect the fan again, and you will see the drastic difference. So now you see everything is moving very smoothly. And as soon as I lift it up, you will see that I start failing. The FPS is going to be 6, 5, moving very slowly. And maybe it will fail. There you go. Oh, now, as you can see, the computer shut off by itself because the excess of heat. And of course, now we can turn it back on and it should work just fine. Once again, we have the fan, we have everything. So that is a kind of failure that you can expect if you don't have the fan in place, or you don't have the thermal paste. And everything. In this case, like I said before, we don't have thermal paste, anything, so it would be like in the worst case scenario. Now press enter, and the computer just is booting up as usual. So that is the main thing. Okay, that's it. So the computer is back and running once again. Okay, I hope you have enjoyed this video. Remember, if you want the full class about how to become a computer technician, you can get it on my website, GabakUSA.com. Everything is going to be in the video description as always. If you like this video, click like, subscribe, and see you in the next class.